Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Again, it's John and Jenna with Flipping Ain't Easy. And hopefully you guys had a good weekend. I can say mine was okay, and I'm sure yours was probably not as okay as mine was, but yeah. So, you know, unfortunately, I gotta say the sales just weren't really great this weekend. So it is what it is. Did some yard selling, and if you watch the video that I put out over the weekend, you guys saw that we picked up a good amount of like concert shirts and things like that, and just other pretty good deals. More shoes. Found another person that had a lot of shoes, and they were really, really cool pairs that they had. So pretty excited about that. Got most of it up over the weekend. Had about at least 30 to 40 items that I picked up over the weekend. So a good percentage of that is up. And that's not even counting the shirts. So kind of a cool story I wanted to share with you guys. Well, let's get started with the ground rules first, though. And that I try to set on all the lives. If you're watching us live today, please do me a favor. Comment or ask your questions in the chat, of course. You help drive the program. But hit the like button either way, no matter what you, even if you're just listening passively, just hit the like button. Now, if you're watching this after the fact, comment down below. And of course, just hit the like button. That's really all I ask. So guys, just kind of a weird thing today. And you know, it's just the weird things that kind of get me motivated to just keep going on eBay, you know, that kind of thing. And it's not even an eBay thing. It's just reselling in general. But, last night I got a couple messages from a couple viewers. I won't put them out there, but asking about the shirts that I put out in the video over the weekend, the concert shirts. And I'm like, I don't know, you know, because I really don't know what I have. And then IC, who's also in the chat a little early today, doing her happy dance. She, we made a deal on three of the shirts. So those are in the mail today, but I went to go to my PayPal to send her an invoice. Right. And I'm like, why do I have $35 in here? Cause I don't keep my money in my PayPal at all. Why do I have $35 from some random person here? And I looked at it closer. I'm like, what the heck? I got a sale on Bonanza over the weekend. I sold a pair of like hiking boots. I don't know if it's a viewer or not, but I don't know why they'd go on to Bonanza to buy something from me. But, you know, I didn't get a notification. It just by happenstance, I went on and saw that Bonanza, I had some money from Bonanza through PayPal. And I mean, they delisted my item off of eBay. Of course, I still had it listed on Posh. So it would have been nice to have had, I did take it off. It would have been nice to have had some kind of communication from them, because I had to go in, log in. I guess, I don't know if is there an app for this site? I don't know. No. I might have to, there's not an app. Mm-mm. So it's like, I'm used to the apps like Mercari, Poshmark, eBay. Whenever there's activity, I'll get, you know, like with eBay, they send me a notification and follow up like two or three emails. It's kind of annoying. And I know I can turn that off, but it just, for right now, it's just annoying. Poshmark, Mercari, I get notifications, but it's going to be problematic with that one or two times a year. And I'm just thinking this might be my one time this year that I'll make a sale.
2023, that's it. You're done.
But yeah, I just don't want to be that seller that's like, man, this guy doesn't follow through. So I was able to get those shoes shipped, the shirts for IC. We were able to get shipped today. And yeah, it's just little quirky things like that that kind of just get me kind of fired up for reselling. I have no idea why, but that's just the way it is. So today I wanted to talk to you guys, and we've hit on this before at the end of the year and all that, but it's really, you know, what are you going to do differently in 2023? I mean, the only people that really should not even be in this conversation are the ones that are just killing it, and anything that they do would probably cause them to, you know, make less sales or not be as efficient. So really, what do you guys really want to do with your business in 2023? What's the one change? You know, and if you don't really know the answer, maybe you should reflect and maybe see what is it? What is there something I can do? Because really, that's, I think, the key that separates good resellers from those who are just kind of stuck in a rut. And that is looking for things that you can do better and more efficiently, or maybe source better. So for me, it's, I know for a fact that all things considered, I mean, let's take the whole economy thing out of it, because there's still people making great sales out there. If I could do something different, if I could go back into time a year ago, it would be, I would not have put, I was still putting all my eggs in the liquidation basket, right? Some people turned me on to the thrift store thing. I did that here and there, and it wasn't the greatest. But then I finally went with American Arbitrage and Biscuit Butt to some yard sales back, I think it was back in like July or August. And wow, I got to tell you, my eyes were opened, and they still are. And I'm really excited for the new yard sale season, even though we've had some yard sales here year round, and we're going to just get more and more as the weather starts warming up. So for me, it's the sourcing, right? It's see, with the liquidation lots I was getting, I was stuck with, buying all these boxes, and who knows what's in them. And yeah, there's some stuff that I put away and I wasn't even going to mess with, because they're like $5 items, but we're talking $10, $15 items. Like, well, when the hell are these going to sell? They probably aren't. And, I was stuck listing those kind of things, and it really hurt my year. And I really turned, I didn't even know really. I mean, I knew about yard sales, of course, but I just didn't know how actually real good that they were. And so I'm very happy to you guys who've turned me on to those, because it's really, it's fun. I like this last time with these shirts. It's just fun. And now it gives me something else to look for, something that I was oblivious to. I mean, we go and pass up all kinds of good stuff at yard sales is because we don't know. There's a lot of people who are veterans at yard sales that, pass up stuff all the time. You see them on their videos and you're like, wow, why do they pass that up? I do it all the time when I'm watching some of these videos. Why did they pass that up? And it's just a learning experience. So I like to learn. I like to gain knowledge that I can, put forth and make money with. So I'd like to see what you guys are planning on doing. Just put up one change. What change can you make this year that you, wish you had done sooner? Rosie Games is in the house, actually quite early. Hi, John and Jenna. Hope you're having a great day. Of course, we got Prosser, who said he's just having in denial about being here early. But, it's not so much that you're early. I mean, it's kind of late where you're at, right? I think it's like around 11 o'clock at night, I think, where you're at in UK. So I'll forgive you on that one. let's see. Nellie Stromsky, my number one change is to focus on less challenging items to package for shipping. I keep gravitating towards breakables because they're so easy to obtain in my area for so cheap. Yeah, I hear you on that. I almost passed up on, I don't know if I showed you guys, I have a house a go-go. Is that what it is called? I think it's what it's called. Yeah. Hash house a go-go, not hash house house a go-go. Hash house a go-go. It's their glass. It's like tilted. And I just thought it was cool. It was in a box. It was $1. And generally I'll pass on those because I don't want to deal with the it being breakable. But the fact that I can sell it 20 plus bucks, I'll just pad the heck out of it and just take my chances if something happens.
And pray it gets there.
But again, I'm into it for $1. So, I just think a lot of times we think when we are going to potentially lose something due to breakage, we start thinking about the money we actually earned on it instead of what we put into it. And if we start thinking of the losses into what we put into that item, I think it's going to be a little easier to just swallow when we just, so fine. I'm out the cost of the item plus the shipping on this. Give them the refund if it comes back broken and move on. That's the kind of way to deal with that. But if you have a good deal like that, I would still gravitate towards grabbing that type of item because someone's going to sell it. Callie Debs is in the house. Hi, everyone. I hope you're doing well. Let's see. Nellie says, a little tidbit. Don't pass on the granny panties and men's vintage undies. I would literally just sell that if I had the ability to source them new with tags. So yeah,
vintage undies.
I guess they have a vintage. Well, as long as there's no vintage marks on them.
Oh God, yeah. Honey.
But she said new with tags. So, Callie Debs, it's raining hard here. Nice day for a chat. Yes, it's kind of
raining here too.
Just a little bit, but we're honestly,
to get more rain tomorrow.
I will work. Rain. I will work with the garage door open when it's like this. I love it. I just love that chill coming in. But that's just me. That's not her.
Yeah. No, I did. I actually had the back slider open so that I could hear the rain and feel the cool, crisp air because I was sweating. I was cleaning and putting away Christmas decor.
Tyler's Trading Post says, hey, I'm here. And then we have Mike Camparelli, our buddy, with the Heath bars. I haven't eaten them all yet. They're still right here, but they're within reach. So,
and I keep seeing the evidence in the trash.
Yeah, I know. let's see. Hey, Jen, I hope you're doing well. We're just waiting for John to finish his makeup. That was before the show. No, it wasn't me. Trust me. She was the one putting her war paint on, not me.
War paint.
That's what I call it, her war paint. Let's see. Aunt White, when giving refunds, do you only refund the item or do you refund shipping too? So this is the thing. It really depends on why I'm refunding why the return even happened. If it's a remorse return, you know, maybe they thought it was a certain shade of whatever color or they just didn't like it. Well, most of my items have shipping on top of the item itself, right? So they're not getting that back. If it's an item where the shipping was built in, well, I can't pull out money for the shipping label. You're not supposed to do that. Let's say it was $20 free shipping. They're getting that full $20 back, even if it's a remorse return, because I can't show what portion of that went towards shipping. I guess you can technically if you have screenshots and all that, but that's why, in my opinion, I mean, there is a small boost to offering free shipping. And then there's also buyers who will click on the free shipping option. But in my opinion, when you're dealing with a return, you don't have to worry about that. Now, if it's on you, you made a mistake, let's say you screwed up or the item was broken, just whatever, and it's not the buyer's fault, then you should refund that part back as well. So it just really depends on the situation. Picky Ricky's in the house. We have Art Betzhold, and Picky Ricky says, folks, look out for train tracks for Hornby, etc. I just listed 5 pieces for about 100 pounds and only paid a 5. So paid $5 for 100 pounds. That's pretty good. Now, Hornby is exactly what? I don't know if that's a UK thing.
Probably a train.
Oh, yeah. I know that, but I don't know if it's a brand that's in the UK or if it's worldwide or whatnot. But okay, appreciate the tip. Tiffany M. Law is in the house. Hi, John and Jenna and everyone. Let's see. I'm just trying to kind of catch up here to what we have. We have Biscuit Butt in the house. So I spoke to him before the show.
Oh, my God, he's alive.
He is alive. I spoke to him before the show. We had a... Sorry, guys, I got my doctor drink here so I can stay focused here. But we're having a discussion about getting invoices for Amazon. And he bought a bunch of stuff that he was expecting to get an invoice with, and it didn't come with an invoice. So we're talking about his adventure of trying to obtain that invoice. And
I don't know why they can't email it to him.
But they try to send the email something different. And it's not quite what is needed. So I ordered the same place that he did to get some DVDs so we can unlock the DVD category. And they gave me an invoice. They shipped him extra DVDs, by the way, but no invoice. So it is what it is on that. Let's see. Prosser's in the house says, hi, John and Jenna, and dog. Yeah, we got our two dogs. Dogs, plural. There's a white one behind her. But
there's another one, right?
Yeah. He's the one that won't go on camera right there. Yeah. He won't go on camera. Aunt White says, flipping ain't easy getting away from the cheap Amazon returns pallets. Yeah, for the most part. I mean, look, I'm still looking at, here's a Home Depot pallet I was kind of looking at. Ooh, that sold for $1,300. No, I'm not buying that. But, you know, there's pallets that I'm looking at. But it's going to pull the trigger right now on some of this stuff because I know that it's really cherry picked, like I talked about in the video. I mean, the yard sales would have to be really, really just bad. And I've found nothing but good stuff at yard sales. As I broaden my horizon, as I learn about more things that have value, I get more comfortable. And I'm not saying I'm an expert by any means at some of these things like shirts and stuff, but I feel like I'm gaining a lot of experience with the shoes, knowing what to look for, knowing what to pass on. And it makes me excited to get out there and do some more stuff. And I really kind of think of liquidation more as an afterthought now, as crazy as that sounds, than, I would. Yard sales right now, I guess you can say, are my go-to thing. I just enjoy it.
And that's the thing, is out here, they can go all year. We don't get weather like you guys do that could stop people from putting their stuff out on the driveway.
Yeah. And you know, the crazy thing is, like, I stopped at this yard sale and I'm like, I don't know that. I mean, I was really, my eyes were, the only reason why I stopped is because I saw a red Nike box on the ground. They had all these clothes set up on racks and they had like a table full of like clothes that they're messing with. And I said, okay, I'm going to stop. I'm going to see what, maybe they have a decent pair of shoes. I did buy a pair of Nikes from them, but it was, like $7. It was pretty decent pair in pretty good condition, Nike Air Max, I think. But they had a bunch of clothes, so I was just interested. They had a little sign behind them, and all these clothes were new a tag. You had Nike, Adidas, some Polo, Ralph Lauren Polo, and Gap, other brands and stuff. And they wanted like $4 to $6 per unit. And I think I ended up picking up a, what was it? Off the top of my head, it was a Puma shirt. And it had some pretty cool, it was like black with like different colors on it. I thought it was pretty cool, maybe for a resale just to try. And I ended up paying $4 for that. And it was the place where I picked up all the shirts. So they had a bag where, the shirts and stuff are just a dollar. So I went in and was going through all that stuff. And I was asking her, well, what kind of deal would you take for all this stuff? I mean, if you're willing to sell new with tags, I mean, perfectly folded, not wrinkled, I mean, really good stuff. If you're willing to sell this that cheap, then what would you take for all of it? Now, I guess the person that would be the one that would make that decision wasn't there. I guess she had COVID or whatever. So they couldn't really make that deal with me, but they said, we're here every weekend. So it's like, all right, well, I'll just go by there next week. And, I'm going to do some homework in the meantime. I have an idea of a lot of the stuff that they had for sale. And who knows, maybe next week, this time I'll be dealing with a large clothing lot. I don't know. We'll see. Liquidation is still going to happen, just on a much lesser scale. Let's see. We have Nelly says, my sales are dead. Yeah, my sales aren't anywhere where I want them to be either. But again, that's why I just want to ramp up on the better stuff. And I have totes of like LPs, records, right? And I will list them every now and then. But, I'm more focused on getting the higher quality stuff out that I have. And I've got a lot of stuff. We've got totes of shoes that we got to put away that we were messing with. Tony Resell says, hi, everyone. How you doing, Tony? We have Sherry Miller in the house. How you doing? Ashley Sim says, hi, everyone. Sales are great last week. Totally tanking this week. And someone said to Biscuit Butt, I think it's not just sales. It's like when it comes to, like, if you do the driving gig, if you drive around and do like the deliveries, it's this weekend was supposed to be really crappy for that. So I don't know, maybe people are just finally looking at, wow, look at what I spent for Christmas. Maybe I need to slow down, and they just weren't buying. I don't know, but not great. And I see is happy with the deal, the shirts. Yes. I'm happy that we worked it out. Hey, I'm all for a quick flip. So enjoy the shirts. Tommy said, bonanza sale. I couldn't believe it. I mean, I really couldn't believe it. I thought someone was playing a joke on me.
Yeah.
And the funny thing is, we used to live out in this particular town in California where this person is. And Jenna's like, I don't know. Do we know this person? You know, then why would they, if they were someone from the channel, why would they even bother with Bonanza? Why not just buy it on
eBay?
Maybe
they just wanted to make it so that we had a sale is all I was
I don't know. Well, if you're watching and you bought something from me on Bonanza, you know, put a note here. That way I can thank you. Eddie Golden III says, not sure if my goal for 2023 should be focus on raising my ASP a few bucks or to bump up my daily listing goal from 18 to 20. So my thing is to maybe do a little bit of both, but
I was just going to say that.
Yeah, a little bit of both, but see, here's the deal. You can't just take this widget. I'll just say this because you can't just take this BlendJet. Okay. And say, all right, now I'm going to take this BlendJet and I'm going to, I have it for 40, but I'm going to start selling this for 50. I mean, if you price it higher than market, and I think this would actually go for more than that. These things were sold out on this colorway for Christmas. But if your market is at a certain price range, just say 40 on eBay, and you go to 50, you're going to have to do some things to get people to even be compelled to buy your item at 50. You're going to have high promoted rates. You're going to have a much better quality listing. So, and that might not even work because people are looking for deals. So to me, it's weird. It looks like it's been open. Okay. But for me, But for me, it's about buying and sourcing higher quality stuff. It's looking for
ASP.
Well, right, average sale price, right? So it's, I think that goes along with sourcing more than anything else, is improve your sourcing. I see a lot of people, you know, that send me, you know, requests to check out their store, and that's the first thing that just hits me, is that wow, this, I'm sure someone out there might want this, but you just need to improve your sourcing. And I upset one of the viewers, by the way, when I made that video a couple of weeks, when I called it crap, and they just was really upset. So I apologize. You know, I just,
believe me, I tried to tell him to tone down the word crap, because not everything everybody sells is crap.
You're right. And I had to tell him, you know, you're right. There are sellers who sell new things on eBay all the time. So I can't say everything that's sold on eBay
is
crap.
You might think is crap is gold to somebody else.
You're right. But, you know, but at the end of the day, it's all temporary.
We have a lot of crap in our store.
Yes.
Okay. And that's one thing that we are going to work on, is getting the crap put in the liquidation boxes and,
you know, improving
a new home where it's not crap to somebody else.
Exactly. And improving sell through rate, I think, is another thing that will benefit someone's store, getting rid of the stuff that's just been sitting around. Let's see. JRKR 1964 might have been very good. So sales for JRKR has been very good. Darren's in the house. Picky Ricky says, I went sourcing Thursday, but started rejecting lower value items, but I do hate leaving money behind. It feels that way, but you get this item, it's like, oh, I can get $10 for this. Right. And so we think we're going to get $10 for it, but if you sell it for 10, you're not going to see 10. So it's, for me, it's just, what's the number? For me, it's closer to 15 to 20. So, yard sale, found these board games. I know I can get 15 to 20. I know I can part them out, make 30 to 40. Found things like that. Then they only wanted $2 or $3. I'm going to pick those up all day long. Michael Biddle says, John and Jenna, this last weekend was awesome. I picked up two Olympic 35 millimeter cameras for $5. Sold both for 180.
Awesome.
Wow. That's what we're talking about right there.
Those are the kind of flips we love.
Yeah. So that's what we're talking about. Tommy says, if you raise ASP, you don't need to list as many to make the same amount. Sell through rate trumps all, though ASP second, number of listings irrelevant. So the number of listings would be more of just trying to build up your, you know, if you have 100 items in your store, right? And on a good weekend, you're making 3 or 4 sales. If you can maybe scale up your store to 200 with the same kind of stuff, the law of numbers will say you're going to get more than 3 or 4 sales. So not necessarily double your sales, but you're going to get more stuff out there that people are going to potentially buy. So, I think there's merit into building, building up your store, but not to the point where you just, I mean, you can't manage. I mean, if you get so much stuff in your store and you're just stepping on it and you have nowhere to put it and it's just a mess, then maybe you're sourcing the wrong things because you don't want to open a museum, right? We talk about that all the time. Ping G says, hi, John and Jenna. How you doing, Ping G? And Nelly says your hair looks great, by the way, Jenna. Oh,
thank you. All natural.
It better, all the time she takes to get ready for these.
No, this is nothing. I don't do it. This is my natural.
Okay, guys, you know what I'm talking about. It's time to go somewhere. You're about to leave the house and it's like, when are you going to be ready? Give me 5 more minutes. I'm sure you guys can relate with me. Sure you can.
Not today. I was.
You were on time, but that's
different. This is all natural, so.
It is.
This is my hair.
But thank you. Aunt White says, hit that like button. I promise it'll give you a sale. Yes.
Yes. Yes.
I would hit the like button if I could, but I'm on StreamYard.
I'll do it.
Okay. Now I got my phone ringer off though, but okay. Bearded PokeTuber says, I got it right this time. Says, hey. Hello. Aunt White says, my goal for 2023 is to find better ways to source. Yeah. Better ways to source or maybe different sourcing methods, because let's say you live in an area and 1 week that's just a mess, just or 2 weeks in a row, it's just a mess, just rain both weekends, and you can't, no one's having a yard, they're canceling their yard sales, right? Well, that's 2 weeks where you don't have a way to source. So maybe if you have a decent thrift store in your area, or maybe a liquidator, liquidation still is okay, but you really got to know what you're looking for. Just find different ways, or even online or retail arbitrage as well, if you're dealing with like Amazon and stuff like that. Picky Ricky says, two things for me, finding higher value items and a good full year of turning my sales into toy wholesale purchases with the next fourth quarter. So yeah, getting ramped up for fourth quarter. I was reading an article where eBay loses money in the first, second, and third quarters of the year. And then in the fourth quarter, they make up all those losses, right? So there's a reason for that. I mean, fourth quarter is, you're going to be your best time to sell in most categories. But don't forget the rest of the year. That's, I would say for me, my fourth quarter was maybe only a little bit better than the other quarters, not counting the summer, those months. But for me, it's just trying to be month to month, try to make as much as I can. I mean, that's obvious, right? But not really focused. There's nothing I really will buy thinking, let me put this aside for the fourth quarter. I'm focused on trying to find ways of getting it sold now. Biff Boffo says, since I'm in a niche, I'm selling QR codes with my shipments, sending QR codes with my shipments to get more followers to my store. And that I know for a fact that works. You know, maybe even, maybe I should make a video on this, but it's, and I did talk about this about a year and a half ago or so, but where you take your Rollo printer and buy these little labels where you can print like up a little coupon code, you know, thank you, and like stick it on the package. That works great. But if you are a niche seller, if you're not, don't bother. You don't get a lot. I don't get a lot of return buyers at all.
I would say niche is really the only people that would benefit from that.
And I only get return buyers because I get some people on the channel that come back and buy stuff. You know, that is just the way it is when you have a YouTube channel. But if you're an everything seller, I wouldn't even bother with all that. Let's see. No one designs in the house. And we also have Ed. Afternoon, John and Jenna. So I hope you guys are doing great. Darren Adams says, had a good day at the bins, found 10 hats, only paid $3.32. So that's what, 33 cents a hat or something like that? That's pretty good. That's really, really good. I'm going to be, you know, like I'm probably going to be selling like more hats that I have, because I have so many hats, guys, that I'm going to start selling hats. This one's a, you can see it's a Star Wars Angels hat. It has Boba Fett on the bill. I thought it was kind of cool, but I mean, how often am I going to wear this thing? I mean, I wear it today for the video, but I'm going to start selling hats and stuff like that. More hats than what I already have up. Ryan Lab says, had a strange GSP issue, global shipping program issue today. Mexico. Person bought it, but asked for invoice was shipped to Mexico. I only ship it to international with global shipping. Not sure how they bought it to a county, but I didn't ship to. So, Yeah. Now, if it's GSP though, if it's GSP, then you're just shipping it to Kentucky and eBay is taking care of the rest. But yeah, that's a good question. You might want to go back and make sure that that policy, that shipping policy that you had, did exclude Mexico. Make sure that was clicked, because that would be the only way that that would have happened. Vintage Memory says, goal for 2023, drop Mercari. My inventory is not that market. Vintage items, not for that market. Vintage items, focus 100% on eBay. Mm-hmm. So yeah, if you've tried Mercari, let's say, and maybe it's just not working out, then don't spend the effort on it. Yeah. We have had good success with, and I'd say the success was better, I'd say, a couple months ago, because a lot of the items that we were moving on Mercari were from these pallets. And as we run out of that stuff, then we start pushing stuff that we are selling on eBay, like the records and the shoes and the stuff that we're finding at yard sales. And it's not as hot of a marketplace. So if you're finding that you're just having a lot of competition with some of the stuff you're getting in pallets, check out Mercari. Now, in your case, because you're dealing with vintage items, you might want to go check out like Etsy or something like that.
Yeah.
And cross list over there. Let's see. Kim Sharp says, hi from Florida, John, Jen, and everyone. How you doing out there? It's about 6:30 at night. So nice to see you. Mel Martin says, hi, John and Jenna. My idea for this year is to list items that go with the season, like cleaning supplies in spring, survival supply, so like mm-hmm. camping stuff, right? Start getting, if you find stuff for camping. I came across this estate sale. They had all these camping things and what do they call them? Survivalist stuff. I think there's another, what do they call them? Doomers or whatever. Preppers. Okay. Oh. Prepper stuff. Sorry. And
Doomers.
That's my term.
Wow.
So preppers and all this stuff, right? And I'm like, okay, that's kind of cool. It was interesting to me. But the problem is when you go to an estate sale, you're going to pay for those items. And it's like, no, I mean, I just didn't see. I even pulled out my phone and was really trying to find things that could be resellable. And for me, not really. But yeah, I definitely agree with you on that. Certainly, this is the time of year. Sporting goods for like golf. For baseball, those things are going to be pretty hot here pretty soon. Ruben Almanza says return rates are up. And that's usually a good sign. I mean, for me, look, if you have higher return rates, that means that you're making more sales, right? In theory. So I really don't get bothered too much with returns just for that reason. It's when I don't have returns, that's not a good sign. That's telling me I'm not really making the sales that I want. Prosser says, I'm restructuring all the platforms so they're more focused and aiming to increase store value when listing and set achievable goals to boost motivation. Yeah, I'd say there's nothing worse than, okay, I'm going to do this month. This is what I want to do. I want to make, you know, whatever your number is. I want to make $10,000 in sales this month and you come nowhere close. It does demoralize you, right? So you have to be realistic. Maybe look year over year. Use that tool that, you know, you can go back now more than 90 days to check your sales. So check what you did last year in January and say, okay, I'm going to try to at least hit that number, if not higher, and see if you can do it. Now, maybe your situation has changed. Maybe you're killing it compared to last year. So make it a reasonable, attainable goal. Ryan Lab says, called eBay. They said, cancel order ASAP, use issue a ship address. They said, if they leave negative, they will remove it. Yeah. If there's an issue with an address, that falls under like sort of out of your control, and you can make that case and have them remove it if you have a negative. IC says, as with most stuff, do your homework. Junk to us may be someone else's treasure. Yeah, it is. And I write that off as my own ignorance. I'll just say the word ignorance. It's not a bad word. People take it as a insult, but it's my own ignorance. You know, when you walk by things at a yard sale that would, you know, like that whole thing, that Space 1999 thing, I almost didn't even ask her. I mean, just out of curiosity, what do you want for this thing? I would never have made that money had I not asked that question. And that was just my own ignorance. I had no idea what that thing was even worth. Callie Deb says, I'm going through old listings and cross-posting them. Yeah, definitely cross-post them. Find another way to get rid of it. But, you know, I was going through some of my listings and just saying, you know what? It's time to end. Just end it and find it and put it in the liquidation pile. You know, I had like a dozen of these three pack of the brand is called Neff, N-E-F-F. And they were like the 3 and 4 pack of kids masks, right? Those things were selling great a year and a half ago, of course, right? But I mean, I still have a couple packs left. You know, trying to sell those, it's just going to be a waste of time. So that goes in a liquidation pile. I mean, there are still people out there that'll drive around with those in the car by themselves, but that's another subject altogether. Savage Picker says, hello, everyone. How you doing? David Gunn says, my goal for 2023 is to niche down. If you can. See, I saw someone talking about that's what you need to do. You need to niche down. You know, if you're a new seller, you're selling everything, that kind of thing. But if it all depends on your sourcing, if you can't find the sourcing that allows you to niche down, like, you know, this lady, okay, that I'm not going to talk about with all the shoes, I need to find more like her because number one, she's not responding to anything that I send her a call. So that's like a dead deal, I think. Okay. So I need to find more outlets to find if I want to sell more shoes. You know, I'm not like Tommy or Ed, that have a person that I can go to or multiple people that I can go to and replenish my stock. So until then I'm off selling everything. And that's just the way it is for me. So everyone's situation's a little bit different. Picky Ricky says another thing I'll be doing is buying the missing pieces for board games in my death pile so I can get rid of that rubbish and make room. So as a tip though, okay, you say you're going to be buying the missing pieces to make your game whole so you can sell that game. But if you go in and look at the comps, a lot of those games aren't worth a whole lot of money unless they're like really vintage or higher in demand, like some like Monopolies that are like way off the cuff. They didn't make a whole lot of them, that type of thing. Generally, though, you're going to be better off instead of finding the pieces that you're missing, go in and sell the pieces that you have in individual lots. So a game that'll sell for $15, $20 plus shipping, right? Will sell for, after it's all said and done, $30 to $40 after everything. I bought an Axis and Allies board game. It's one of my favorite games as a kid. Love that game. And you have all the country pieces, all the infantry pieces, right, for each country. So there's 5 countries there selling for $10 a piece. Free shipping. So I made like $6 on each one of them. You've got the other little pieces that like the board pieces. You've got the board itself. You've got the game rules, dice, and all these things. I think I've sold everything but the game board, and I've already made like $40. It was a $3 purchase at a yard sale.
Yeah, so sometimes you'll notice that if you piece things out, you make more money. We do that a lot. We did that with the parts for a Roomba vacuum that we had, and we just, instead of selling it as a whole, you sell it in parts and it sells for more than what you would get for the whole unit.
Yeah, we had one that just went DOA, and I'm sure it's a battery issue, but you know, you take the bin, you know, take it out, clean it out real good. You take the charger, the charging base. You can even go as far, if it's a more popular model, you can take the go in there and take the wheel assembly off. And people are buying these things, right? Because they want to go out and spend $200-$400 for a new one. They just, if you have a $20 wheel assembly that they can just take apart with a few screws and put it back on and make theirs work, then that's what people are going to be doing. Especially now that when money's tight, people are going to be looking for ways to get by without having to buy brand new at full retail prices if they can help it. Kina says, afternoon, everyone. I'm going to behave since it's Monday.
Please. No need to behave ever. Who needs that? That's boring.
Kim Sharp says, my number one change is a cross list more. I'm not sure why I keep putting it off. Because it's just it's just an, well, first of all, it's not something new to you. So because it's foreign to you, cross-listing, it's like, oh, there's a learning curve on a new site. Once you get the hang of it, it's like, okay, you can put that in your routine where you're doing like 5 or 10 a day or more, and it's really nothing after a while. So, and of course you can check out the cross-listing tool that we have that I like to use. It's Prime Lister. They give you a 2-week period without any kind of payment up front, not even a credit card. You could try it for 2 weeks, 100 listings to see if you like it.
Love that tool.
Yeah, it's a good tool. I like it. Ken PDX says, hi, John and Jenna and all fellow flippers. So how you doing today? I want to say Portland every time I see
it. I was just going to say that.
Yeah, because that's the code for Portland, Oregon, and Amtrak. Ryan Lab says, well, had eBay call me, LOL. I'm wondering why they had you called. Maybe it's about something else that you guys are talking about. Savage Pickers, my plan is to add value to my store and up the average sales price. So yeah, and I just really, really think that it's part of that plan has to be eliminating the stuff that's just not selling and has a lower ASP.
Yeah,
that's already listed. Picky Ricky says, I don't think you're allowed to sell used underwear, but yet I do see them on, you do see those on eBay?
Oh my God.
With or without the track mark?
They sell some really,
really
bad,
okay,
terrible.
That's like, you know, you guys know that you can find like any like ketchup packet from any, yeah,
like Chick-fil-A.
Let's see, used underwear. No results. Okay. So what? There is no, if you're looking up underwear, right?
Don't put that.
Well,
you're going to have millions.
I'm looking at something else.
Oh, you're looking at
yours. Yeah, I don't have any underwear. Hold on. The wrong. So if I look up used underwear, there's no way.
Oh my gosh. You said where? War.
Under war?
Under war.
Oh, God. Sorry, guys. I've never been the smartest guy in the room. You guys know that. Sold items.
It's but, just pretty.
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
Says a lot of, well, here's one. A lot of two men's Lululemon used boxer briefs. We're not having an earthquake. It's just my leg. Sorry. A lot of two men's Lululemon used boxer brief shorts, size medium. $24.99.
It says used.
It says used. New other. Because you can't sell. Well, there. Well, yeah. Oh, my God.
Okay. All right. So we're going to move on.
Wow. They say pre-owned, but they use them. They see, this is how they do it.
Oh, my
they
God.
Sell them as, they sell them as brand new, but they put pre-owned in the listing to get around it. But yeah, just look up used underwear and look at the sold comps and scroll down a little bit. You'll see exactly what we were wowing about. God. So, oh, wow. I used to wear those. I used to wear those like as a baseball player. We actually have to wear those. Well, the straps. That's all I'll say. I don't want to get too. That's wow. Really? Who would buy a used one of those, though?
Okay, come on. No, they don't know what you're talking about.
They know. They know. No one designed to. My new year resolution is to laugh more to the bank. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. I agree. Love that's a good that. One. But let's forget about making it a new year's resolution. Let's, because that's talking about it. Let's just make it happen. Tommy says there's a huge underground fetish for soiled vintage jock straps. Okay, you said it. And that's model dirty socks. Yeah, and there's people buying it. And they're bidding each other. They're fighting each other on eBay for it.
Oh, my God.
A vintage boy small bike jockstrap pre-owned, $35, 5 bids. What? You can't make this stuff up.
Oh, my God.
There's some different. And it's not on Poshmark. It's on eBay. It's on eBay. We're looking at eBay right now. Eddie says, I sell a lot of vintage marks. We're talking about the toys, right? I don't get it, but okay. Jenna's going to sell John's granny panties now. Hey, boxer briefs here. That's a little TMI, but marks on undies. Ken says, my goal is to be more organized and business oriented, not let me bring being at home and letting things distract me. Mm-hmm. That can happen. Like this thing we're dealing with right now, if you're trying to work while you're watching this, I'm not saying going anywhere. We have 109 people, so we want to keep you here. But for me, it's like when I'm working, right? And I'm just feeling like listening to like eBay talk, maybe sometimes it motivates me too. I'll put it on a, like a, flip it on a 10 minute video. And it's like, geez, I want a longer one, like a live stream to listen to. So I'm not distracted.
Just wait until you get to.
No, I'm sure. The flipping sports guy says, Tommy, how often have you been asked to model the Hokas? Oh man, just when I thought I saw it all on eBay. I'm frightened now to go back on. I know, like, we need to get rid of this. I don't want to see that. Kevin Hawthorne's in the house from Lakeland, Florida. How you doing, Kevin? Morning Chores LLC, a hobby farm in Central Florida, says my number one 2023 change: list more, list often, list better, and list. So far, it's working. Listed 190 items in a week. And go live on the 13th through the 18th. Go live on the 13th through the 18th. They aren't even showing my sales are up. And, you know, here's the thing. You cannot sell something that's in your garage, in your basement, in your attic, in your whatever, if it's not listed. So list, right? I'm wondering how many sales I'm missing out on just some of the stuff that's in my tubs, you know, right now as we speak. Let's see here.
He says pay extra for racing stripes.
Noah Design says, Tommy, quick erase your browser history evidence. evidence. Tommy says, not once, Paul. They can just tell my feet ugly, I guess.
Yeah, how many times have you had to?
Oh, yeah. The model those Hokas. Yeah. Noah Design says, $40. What a steal. Oh, yeah. No joke. Sold a heavily soiled vintage Duke jockstrap on Poshmark, $40 in one day. Oh. Why? And no one designed, probably got out.
He said heavily soiled.
Soiled with what?
Don't. Oh my God. He said $40. What a steal.
I could get melons of DVDs. Melons of DVD CDs for 50 cents each.
Where is this live going?
Wow. I hope your children are not around. Nature Made in Utah says, do I have to do anything special for overseas sales? Just got my first Australian order. No, not really. I mean, look, if it's something that can be broken, you know, if we don't know how those people overseas in any country handles your package. It's time to get it off the plane. They just throw it down off of the 747 or whatever it is. So maybe double box it, pad it up, or just bubble wrap the crap out of it. That should work. Just give it a little bit more extra care than you normally would when you're packing it up. Jovial Juggler says, happy National Clean Your Desk Day. Well, I didn't get that memo.
He didn't get the memo.
I didn't get the memo.
He doesn't ever know what day is Clean Your Desk Day.
No. The flipping sports guy says, I was dying when I saw Joe's IG post about the guy asking him to try on the drawers. Yeah.
Wow.
Oh, no. God. My number one reselling change for this year is migrating my items to a new eBay store. My old one is a glitch that negatively affects the estimated delivery date shown to buyers. eBay support is no help. And you, if you've done everything to check your handling time on all of your, not just one of them, but all of your shipping policies, make sure that's not, you know, at a higher number. But Ryan Labs says, I learned on refunds, not just refund or just refund, including shipping upon receipt. Note the shipping expenses on loss sheet. Yep. Ed says, I heard Home Depot liquidation is really good. Have you ever gotten one, John? One of my first liquidation lots that I bought was two pallets of stuff. And you know, they went through them, but that's fine. There's still some stuff in there, tools and all kinds of stuff. We made money. We only spent a few $100 for them. And, you know, a lot of tools that, a lot of door handle sets, you know, like
doorknobs.
Yeah. That like your front door, like the full set with the deadbolt and all that. You'd be surprised if you can, get these sets together and have the packaging and everything. You can make pretty good money with those. Tyler's Trading Post. I made two sales and one of the guys wants to know what else I have in stock. Could it be a scam or could he just want to know? Yeah, I would look. I think a lot of times our radar is on potential scammers, but scammers are so far, few and far between. I would look at it as an opportunity. So say, hey, I have a bunch of these things I haven't listed yet. Let me know if you're interested. I'll be glad to list them, you know, that type of thing. You know, of course, keep the focus of your conversation to that, you know, you'll be selling them on eBay, because you don't want eBay to think you're trying to take sales off, right, off of eBay. You know, eBay's weird that way. Ryan Lab says Home Depot clearance is sometimes good. Medebo slicers I got for 10 cents each, normally $6 to $7 each. Yes.
Do you have any tissue in here?
No.
I gotta step away.
Okay. So Mad Hatters, we have an earthquake going on here. Hold on. Sorry about that. My number one change would be to sell on a platform besides eBay. Any recommendations for apparel and hat sales on sites like Mercari, Depop, Curtsy, and other? I love Poshmark. Poshmark's great, but see, here's the thing. We didn't play the Poshmark game, and that's why we went away from Poshmark. We're ambassador level 2. I don't know what that means to anyone, but that's what we are on Poshmark, because we have just pretty strong following. We did the whole game, the follow others and all that, but it got old and cumbersome, and we just were done with it. And a lot of the stuff we were getting weren't clothing or shoes. And I know you can sell more than that, but at the time, that's what it was about. And with the Prime Lister tool, you can go in and share your closet. And that's the thing. You got to be listing and sharing your closet. But who has time to do that? Go through every listing and share. So you use that tool and you can set it up. Like, I'm done listing today. The last thing I'm going to do is go on and click on Poshmark. And she does it. And you could share your closet. And then turn off your monitor and just walk away and do other things, photo or whatever you're doing. And the whole while, like every 20 seconds, it's sharing a new listing. So it doesn't look like a bot's doing it. And that has really helped us get a lot more sales of our shoes and some of the clothing items. So that's where I would go and check out. But check out the link down below. Let's see. Tommy says, anything anyone can Google and buy, so can everyone else. I agree with that. But as far as sourcing, I'm sure you're not Googling your the shoes that you buy. I'm sure you have made relationships with people that are within your area that you don't even have to have. I'm just assuming this, but I don't see how you can keep your cost of goods low if you're having them shipped to you. But you're making relationships, and now they know that you're a consistent customer and buyer. You're going to get deals more often than not, and they're probably going to hit you up more often than not because you're consistent. So that's just, I don't know your business model, but I'm only assuming that's how you're successful. No One Design 2 says, I would never get Home Depot, Lowe's, Ace pallets, bought it once, and it was a nightmare, never again. You can get some pretty bad ones. And like, yeah, I said,
some are bad.
Yeah, 80% of the liquidation stuff you find is just going to be horrendous. And unless you can go and see it yourself, and some of these sites will show you multiple views of what you're looking at, give you a manifest. If you can't do that, then it's not something I would get into. Let's see. It's the great thrifter, Charlie Brown. Wow. How do y'all just got here? My biggest change will be doing more older listing adjustments for algorithms instead of listed and forget it. Yeah, you got to keep maintaining your items. So a lot of people will, think, hit my listing goals, but they'll never spend the time on their listings. They'll let those listings just recycle over and over and over again. And that's definitely something you want to avoid. Jackie Blechner says, my items were all inherited, nothing in it besides time. Why do I have such a hard time pricing? Spent more time researching. It drives me insane.
I have that problem too.
Well, I mean, number one, as you get through, let's say I have a bunch of these widgets here and I don't know anything about them. But after you get through the first few, you start getting an idea, you get gaining experience and knowledge about what they are and what their general value is. But, you know, always take a look at the comps. And if you don't know what it's called, you just don't know what it is.
Don't forget Google Lens.
Yes.
I'm telling you, it's a lifesaver sometimes.
And then what you do is you take that. Sometimes when you're doing the search on Google Lens, you'll scroll down and see an eBay listing for that very same thing. So you can go and click on that And then it, if you have your eBay app open, it'll take you to that listing in your eBay app and then just put sell one like this. So now you have a template to actually list that item with, and you have a general idea of what they're selling it for. Now, I would always say use your comps, go into Terapeak and or just use your 90-day comps and see what those sell for as well, so that you get an idea. Biscuit Butt says, I'll take your Derek Carr stuff before you throw them out. LOL. Yeah, that's funny.
You will never throw them out.
I absolutely think Derek Carr is like one of my favorite athletes. Just the person that guy is. I mean, just a genuine man. And but I will be rooting for him no matter where he goes. I'm totally upset at my organization, my team, for doing what they did. But this is not a football channel, so I won't go into all that.
So the Derek Carr stuff stays.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I got an autographed football. I mean, look, Howie Long doesn't play for the Raiders anymore. I mean, he's like 60-something years old. I mean, he's retired. So it's just like that. It's like he's an alum for the Raiders. So I'm happy to have it. And I just got a Tim Brown autographed picture for Christmas. So that's gonna same kind of thing. Lisa's Peculiar Treasures. I just found a taxidermy jackalope today at estate sale. Does anyone know if there is any restriction selling on eBay? That's interesting. A jackalope. I don't think so, but maybe. Oh, I don't know. I see antlers. I don't know. Yeah, there's some baby jackalope head, rabbit, bunny. I don't know. I don't think there is. Check the comps. That's kind of what we're doing right here. Just don't use keyword Velcro. Don't use onesie. I'm sure there's a few other ones there.
Yeah.
Rosie Game says, big glitch on eBay, guys. Tip, if you find an item with zero views for several days, do a search for your listing. If it's not there, relist. Do not sell similar. Relisted each item, problem solved. Huh. I haven't come across that problem. Tommy says, my dead grandmother even knows about liquidation pallets. Going to be hard to make money nowadays. Yeah, it's not because, you know, well, yeah, the liquidation bins are, I think, are the one that's killing it, but they're not as good of quality as they used to be. And that's the thing that's, I mean, I could still go on right now and get a liquidation pallet, but it's just nowhere near what it was.
Yeah, there's too many hands in the cookie jar.
Mad Scientist says, hello, I'm late. Well, I'm late getting to your comment. Gee, I'm way behind. What's new? Nelly says, I bought a Dick's Sporting Goods pallet years back, and it was loaded with all high-end clothing. It was nice, once-in-a-lifetime deal. We bought on liquidation.com like 3 years ago. We bought, I guess, man, it was a huge pallet. They had, I guess it was a sporting goods store that went out of business, and we got a lot of like stuff with tags. And
wasn't that, what's the name of that sport?
Big Five.
Big Five.
A lot of it was Big Five, but there's other.
We ones got that, a lot.
Yeah.
And we made way more money than we paid for it.
Piggy Ricky, I've already replaced money back into my wallet that I spent at Christmas by sending out Boxing Day offers to watchers. General everyday public knowledge pallets are dead. Can't make steady income off of that. You need to find pallets that's not public knowledge. Yeah.
Right.
I mean, that's the case. That's the thing. I mean, Vegas isn't a very good place for that. Let's see. Biscuit Butt says, Tommy, there's more profit in your grandmother's liquidation palace nowadays. Yeah, I think that I just read that, didn't I?
No, I think he's responding.
There's more profit in your grandmother than liquidation palettes nowadays. Wow, that's bad, Archie. The Tommy Bernard podcast says, she turned a lot of tricks in her day.
Wow.
See, I was on Archie about that. That's not right. The flipping sports guy, majority of what everyone sells is crap. A lot of it. And I think that, you know, I guess the whole point of me even bringing that up that way is because I think there are many sellers, not everyone, many sellers on eBay that really think highly of the crap that they're selling, maybe too highly of the crap that they're selling. And if they get beyond that and see it for what it is, they'll move on to better stuff. 95% is crap though. Maybe not 95, but it's pretty high. Mark Sedek says, hi to you both and everyone in the room. No one wants to spend money after Christmas. Great before Christmas. And someone turned off the tap. No sales for 10 days now. Well, that's That's no good. Videos for life, as long as it has a chance to sell something in the future.
Putting John out on the corner if that happens.
Oh yeah, but the business would be great. Buy one of those jock straps and
he would be on Fremont Street.
That's right. Have you ever been down to Fremont Street and you have like the old lady that's out there and she just has like nothing on virtually? And I'll be that guy out there.
This live is going in so many directions.
Charlie Brown says, I call my good stuff crap. I don't build an emotional attachment that way.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, you can't.
Let's see. Lisa's had decent sales in last four days, but almost everyone is accepting low offers. Yes, accepting and making low offers. I agree with that. Flipping Sports Guy says, when most people focus on ramping up their inventory, usually means there's a bunch of junk added to just the listing number. Yeah, I mean, that's what I say. Don't cheat. If you're going to up your store, keep the same level or better goods that you have right now. I think the mail lady's here. That's why the dogs are growling. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we're using our tubs now. So, of course, every time she comes, we're on the live, right? But
she always, that's really the only time.
So we really can't go out and say, hey, can you bring me more bags? I think I had a chance to last week and I forgot those big bags. So I'm using clear totes to put the stuff out in front. She returns the totes, but she wouldn't have to make the extra, you know, walk back to the door if she just brought me some more bags. But I mean, I don't know.
She works harder, not smarter.
Tiffany says, keep getting low offers, but my sales are so slow, I'm accepting them anyway. I did make a nice $93 sale on an old painting. I had the house that was stuck in my closet for over a decade.
Wow, that's pretty cool.
It says, my flea market is still open during a heavy downpour. I was able to come out with 10 good pairs of three, which have sold already. Well, that's awesome. I see, can still stop by rained out sales and ask, did yard sale in my living room once. My neck of woods is pretty safe. Yeah, but I don't know if I do that here in Vegas. I don't
know.
That's why I don't like having the local pickups here. I just don't trust people. I don't, some people come and they're like really like shady sometimes or sketchy. Ed got around 100 hats for $30 and might get another 100. That's awesome. Blithering Rando says, I'm an everything seller. My tiny store is 16 followers. But I've only noticed one return buyer. One person views just about everything I post, which is kind of weird, but nice. Yeah. But as you build, you know, your store and your following, you'll get more of those people. Yeah. But if you're not a niche seller, it's not going to be as common. The flipping sports guy. Oh, yeah. My dog is not happy.
He's mad at me.
Chew. Anyway, nice thing about sports cards, collectors stick with people that do them well. So I get a handful of repeat buyers. Yes, that's very, very true. And if they know you're offering a discount for return buyers, that helps too. FSG Paul, I sell in a very narrow niche and I have lots of repeat buyers. IC says, sorry, I'm chatty Kathy today. I've saved rocks, bins, et cetera, for my old appliances. One thin fridge glass shelf, new is $50. So I haven't, you'd be surprised. It's like that won't sell and it will because there's someone looking for that part.
Somebody's kid broke it or husband broke it and they need to replace it.
I'm being called a doomer now. But you know what I mean? Let's see.
He's not a doomer.
No, I don't.
He listens to some doomers.
I don't listen to him. You know, I have, we have extra stuff in our pantry, but you know, as far as like, If all hell breaks loose and nuclear war hits, we're done.
Well, I just had to go through all of our canned goods, and those are all expired. So not all of them, but
IC says some estate sales have 50% off on last day. It might be. I mean, they probably do, but it's like, man, maybe that's the key. Go the last day and see what you can get. Blithering Rondo says eBay let someone from the Mariana Islands buy an item for me, then wouldn't let me buy postage to the app. When I went to USPS, I had to fill out a custom slip and the shipping price doubled. Okay, so what you could do is go to Pirate Ship and buy your shipping there, and they have pretty good international rates too.
Mariana Islands, where is it?
Mariana, I don't know. Kid Wilson says, I made it the entire year being my own boss, selling stuff I bought at Goodwill. After adding up all the taxes, fees, etc., I made $2,000 profit off of $14,700 in sales. After taxes, I might be even. Wow. Well, you know, that's the thing. So I'm assuming that you're buying these things, you're probably paying too much. So, I mean, I would start looking for stuff you can sell at the same type of price point or more, and at a lower price. Now, you're probably not going to get that too much at Goodwill because their prices are fairly high.
Yeah.
But, you know, check out the yard sale game and that kind of thing. I can tell you, I haven't been into a Goodwill in months because the yard sales are pretty darn good out here. Piggy Ricky has 5 boxes of Energizer torches on hand. Let's see, the Monster Loon's in the house. Hello, Flip and fam. Happy New Year's.
Hey.
I guess the Mariana Islands is a U.S. territory. It doesn't cost any more than Hawaii or California. Mm. I've never shipped to Mariana. I don't know. way behind. Thomas is pointing out also takes more time to create 10 listings and 1 time to clean. For some reason, people don't value time. Like I have these board games. They're going to be very easy for me just to take a couple pictures of each of the parts. And I've got multiple listings and I know those are going to sell based on the comps faster than the game will. Jim B, I have a tape dispenser that sits on my desk, but the tape roll is always tough to remove since the roll finishes. Do you have this issue? No, I have just one where the thing lifts up. So time to buy a new $10 tape roll. Whoops. Moving my desk around in my lighting. Let's see. That was my thought, Tommy. Is an extra $10 to $15 worth all the time? It's not all that much time, though. Really. I mean, I have all the – when you're selling a game, right, that's open, you're going to show the pieces anyway. And so I'm figuring, do I want to sell this once for $15 plus shipping, or do I want to sell it for $40 in 5 different listings? So it just depends on what you want to do, but it doesn't take that much time for me. Nelly parts out everything. The flipping sports guy, I never quite understood the game parting out because there's a lot of people that are missing parts. They lose the pieces they want to play. They don't have boardwalk anymore. And they reach out and on eBay and someone's selling.
Parting out like anything. You can part out a lot of things. Like the vacuum I was talking about. He sold one wheel by itself. You know? Oh no.
Really?
Nelly.
Parts in a jar. No. But are there any comps for those? No. Really?
Oh my gosh.
A hot fart in a jar.
Have got to be
10 kidding. Bids for
Look at that one. Look at this one.
Look at this one.
No, go down.
No, look above. Right here. 1 of 1 certified fart in a jar. $200.
What is I'm selling wrong the wrong with thing. This world?
We need to go right now and get some like beans and just have at it.
What is happening?
Wow.
You
gotta
be kidding me.
On as far as the jock straps and underwear, there is not a pre-owned, so people are gonna be selling them as new with the pre-owned in the title.
Yeah, that's what most of those
I'm say. Bothered right now.
I know.
And I'm starting to smell something that's
it wasn't me.
But look, there's one fart in a jar fresh from the oven.
Wow.
I'm sorry, guys. I just don't understand what's going on in this world right now.
You know what, though?
He loves my
this.
Gosh.
This is
funny.
This is the humor he likes.
Wow. Are you serious? Okay. Lisa's Peculiar Treasures. I got box a day with Nintendo 64 game instruction booklets. Would it be good to sell individually or better lotted up? I think about 20 of them. I would go through and see if you have anything that's really valuable in those games and pull the games that have good value and lot the rest of it with the system. Look,
Archie just sent me this.
That's horrible. And is there a money back guarantee if you don't get the result you're looking for? If it comes out as like
disturbing.
If it doesn't have a smell, are you, and how can you prove that? I guess you don't have to on eBay. Baubles, blings, and evil things. I walked into okay looking up used underwear.
Well, I'm sorry. I told you this live is like no.
I mean, it doesn't. I mean, how that is. It doesn't get any easier flipping farts in a jar, though.
I mean,
$200.
$200 plus $11.15 shipping.
What happens if the jar shows up broken?
I don't know.
I just want to see a video of someone opening up their package and what they're doing with it.
Don't want to know.
Oh my.
Quite frankly.
Oh my goodness. Flipping sports guys who use underwear going to show up in his Google search and Facebook ads now. Anytime he starts with a U, it's going to be and I'm gonna get farts all the time. I'm like
My God.
Baubles, blings, and needful things. Tommy, seriously, I thought you found and old some of those and sold some of those sports banana hammocks. I did sell some one soiled vintage jockstrap on Poshmark, Lisa. Wow.
Oh my gosh.
Yes, we've talked about it too many times, but yeah. Oh, I mean, my goodness. I know, then I'm getting unknown callers, probably selling me some unwanted farts. Let's see. Tonight, Ed is going to talk about his 75% off sale. Bob Senior 15 says, John and Jenna, there is hope in people. USPS package was lost last September. Gave them a full refund. Got an email today that I just arrived, and he sent me a check. That's awesome.
Wow.
That's awesome. I had an Amazon person that said, you know what? This didn't show up as delivered. On one of my Amazon sales, but I just want to let you know that it arrived. So it's like, hey, that's cool, you know. So there are people
there
out there
are
that
good people, yeah, honest people.
I like to think most people are honest people, and they're not trying to buy farts and underwear on eBay. So let's see. I'm trying to catch up.
What Prosser say?
Flipping ain't censored channel
tonight.
That's right. We might get demonetized on this one. So
we may not be back on Friday.
Yeah. Oh, melon is equals a Gaylord. Okay. Oh. I've never heard of a melon.
Nah, I've heard of melon.
I mean, we're talking about farts and underwear. You start talking about melons. What do you think I'm going to think of? Sorry. She's talking about used bras here in a minute.
Okay.
If liquidation was still good, there's no way John would be leaving the house, let alone cleaning shoes. That's what Archie told me. Yeah. But I got to say, though, I mean, really, I do enjoy the yard sale thing. I'm going to start wearing my GoPro here pretty soon. I just went to two.
You were supposed to do
No, that. No. I just wanted to make sure I was focusing on getting some stuff. So that was my focus.
He has trouble.
No, I don't. No, I would do the same, but I just don't want to have to mess with it. Let's see. Trying to catch up to you guys. Tommy uses Flip every day for cross-posting. It's fine for that and the price point. Yeah, it's free. That's a free one. But, you can't get some of the features that, making offers to likers and, sharing with people who follow you. Liquidation is still great. Had another record year. Hey, that's awesome. Liquidation pros. Watch your videos many times. Liquidation is good when you find good liquidation, but it's just nobody should be able to disagree with me here that what liquidation you find right now, there's no way it's better or the same than what it was in 2019. Yeah. I promise you that it's well picked through. Bearded PokeTuber, give their rules a quick read to see how they word it, but yeah, I know people who have gotten banned from selling on there before. I don't know where that was. I'm trying to skip through your comments so I can get to some questions here. Wanda says, would you consider doing a video explaining how buyer should update their settings to allow getting the offers to watchers? I found many who do not know. Should update their settings. I didn't know that. So if you can share that with me, maybe I'm just oblivious to that, but how a buyer would do it, I don't know, because I don't buy a lot on eBay anyway. Maybe supplies when I get my coupon. That's about it. KB Flips. Hey, John, what's your take on eBay taking away the listing quality report in February? Honestly, I was getting the same thing anyway from that report. I was getting, offer free returns to get top rated, top rated plus seller status, and just a lot of stuff that said if, if you do this and do that on certain listings, and it really wouldn't have made a difference. I really didn't get a whole lot of use of it. I checked it out a couple times and just thought, well, it doesn't apply to me. But maybe if you're in a niche, maybe you can focus on it. Like, how many, what ranking are you in this category, right? And I'll never rank high in, I'm probably starting to rank higher in shoes, but I'll never rank high in a lot of categories because I'm selling a lot of different things. Sold a 1930 German 8-day cuckoo clock today for $180. So today was a good day. Awesome.
Yeah.
Kia hit the like and got her first sale. See?
Woo!
It works. Got testimonials right here. Silver Hair Stacker says, why haven't more discovered government surplus and military surplus auctions? Last 5 years have been 35% of my sales. It just, you know, stumbling on it. How did you come across that when you, before you bought anything military or surplus, how did you learn about those auctions? And I think a lot of people in that same boat, they just don't know. Let's see. Trying to, we're about an hour and 15 minutes in. So we got about 15 or 20 minutes of this. It's actually pretty fun.
Yeah.
And some of those, let's see, I'm getting in the middle of conversation, so that's fine. But Nelly learns a lot from trash to cash, a whole new show about farts in a jar. Yeah. Yeah.
We don't have any information on it. We don't know how to do it.
I mean, that would be a viral video.
I just
ordered a fart in a jar. Maybe I'll do one. Okay.
No, you will not.
Used Undies farts in a jar. My first live in a few weeks, and you guys gotten off your rocker. No, this is our New Year's resolution. We're gonna spice things up on this channel. No, it's not. We just sometimes we get off the rails. I'm sorry.
We are actually funny, okay.
Back in the mid 70s, my brother, this is Jovial Juggler. My brother ripped one in a clean, empty wine bottle and capped it really quickly. When funk grew in the jar, the teacher gave him an A for effort. Wow.
Wow.
So that would have sold for more than $200 on eBay. Drew sold some enlargement cream. I got a lot from 888. Guy that bought it asked me if it was fresh. Wow.
And wow.
I'm wondering what you said. Good day, guys. Just got in kangaroo back. Skips a bit jumpy today. Was a wild ride. Have fantastic 2023. Keep up the good work. let's see. Going down here. Tommy says, most YouTubers just buying stuff from places we can all Google and trying to sell affiliate codes and actually make money from, you have found a source with good stuff. Yeah. That's something I always think about, you know, it's, you get a lot of YouTubers and unfortunately, you know, I talk about it a lot on this channel, but, it's like, okay, this is a good topic. This is a good topic. And you're just waiting for it. When's the sell pitch going to happen? And then boom, halfway through the video, but you guys can buy that here for me or, you know, learn it for me. And it's like, yeah. And so just, if you're new to the game of reselling, whether it's this channel or any other channel, you know, I will like push the sponsors once in a while. Every once in a while, I'll tell you about the merch we have. You want to flip an easing thing, it's all down below, but I'm not going to, try to sell myself out like that on like a program I'm selling, or, you know, here's a bunch of videos I've done, that kind of thing. I just can't. I did the online sellers retreat. I think that's what it was called. Heck, I can't even remember what it was called. Back in October. I'm getting old, you know? And so for me, I did that, and they had a thing where you could actually push your program. You could actually go on and advertise, you know, whatever thing you're selling or promoting for your channel. And for me, I'm like, no, I'm not doing that. And I mean, more power to the people that do, but to be honest with you, it's like, why aren't you giving that information with your, you know, your regular free videos? And, so you'll never see me, you know, make a program or some kind of thing that's going to charge you for extra information. I just don't like it. I don't like it at all. So let's see. other than farts in a jar, I'm not really seeing anything else here. Sorry, a lot of talk about that, but we had a really fun time on this. You know, I'm really, really horrified right now with eBay because of what some of the stuff that they're selling. And I'm going to start, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to be looking at some of these sellers and their feedback. I want to see what the heck's going on here. I'm just curious how many chargebacks and return these people get, but you know, that's just me, my twisted curiosity. But,
we're going to be here Friday.
We are going to be here Friday.
Friday's my birthday.
Yeah, we're going to go out and eat and stuff after her birthday. So we'll make time to share that day with you guys. But beginning of the year is a good time to figure out what changes you're going to make. You should be making changes constantly, but there's no time better than just the start of a new year. Start fresh. Reflect back on the previous year. And what are they writing in here? Oh, hit the like, guys, or John will start selling farts in a jar. Yes, but just know that changes are going to benefit your business. And it's just yet another example of how sometimes flipping ain't easy. And I want you guys to have an excellent start to your week. Avoid the farts in the jar. And we'll talk to you guys very soon. Take care.